My name is Don Young. I'm 6'3", 200-pound guard. Here's footage of my workout and a few of my highlights. Hope you enjoy.
STL Derby, I'm like magic to Kareem, man. You tell me I ain't worthy. I ain't speaking about a jersey, I'm speaking about income.
Get your head out, Elizabeth, here come the big one.
I put more money in the community than you got in your budget. I want my money, put your advance to the toilet, then flush it. My last stance be a stance of a general custard. I hot dog cause I can, I got the cheese and mustard. I got the stats of a Hall of Fame in just two records. That's why I'm back up at the Super Bowl with Julius Peppers. I got that can't stop, won't stop in my vein. That's why they can't stop, won't stop screaming the name.
Nelly, Nelly,
go tell a friend to tell a friend. I'ma keep the same brand whether I lose or win. Up or down 10, I'ma fight to the end. Let's go.
Ain't no way they can stop me now, Nelly, cause I'm on my way. I can feel my ring coming. It's the blood of a champion running deep inside my veins. Too much pride to be running. I'ma get what I can and more, even if my blood, my sweat, and my tears don't mean nothing. It's the heart of a champion.
It's the heart of a champion. Still the same, I'm shooting off of my ring with Peyton Manning to aim. Can't stop me from scoring, so they result in just hacking. So that's three of us now, me, AI, and Shaqin. Come and look to the eyes I say, of a man with more heart than Hallmark on Valentine's Day. I'm the one that you've been raving about, like Ray Lewis. I think you watch a goal and change your route, cause you don't know if I'm blitzing or if I'm sitting there eating, waiting for you to go a trip, drop back and throw up a pick, man.
Ain't no way they can lose. 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 Ain't no way they can stop me now, Nelly, cause I'm on my way. I can feel my ring coming. It's the blood of a champion up and deep inside my veins. Too much pride to be running. I'ma get what I can and more, even if my blood, my sweat, and my tears don't mean nothing. It's the heart of a champion.
It's the heart of a made on high, it's worth it. If hard work pays off, the easy work is worthless. My work habit ain't no habit, man. I do it on purpose. I push myself to the limit, so my talent is service. So now it's curtains and drapes on anybody who hates, disliking what I'm reciting, biting what I've been writing. I've been dogfighting, scratching and clawing on every height, trying to make you remember me like you remember the Titans. Since I'm a warrior, my daddy was a soldier, a Vietnam vet, a little dirty. Supposed to whip up your town and test the roasters. Even like Folgers, man. I'm young, black, and rich. As good as it gets. And giving your point guard fits. Think he the same pressure, man. But he ain't seen. Oh.
Ain't no way they can lose. 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 Ain't no way they can stop me now. Nelly, cause I'm on my way. I can feel my ring coming. It's the blood of a champ.
Don Young, 6'3", 200-pound guard. Don Young, 6'3", 200-pound guard. They're going to be shooting a couple of... Don Young, 6'3", 200-pound guard. Here's a footage. Here's a footage. Here is footage.
3, 2.
How you doing? My name is Don Young, 6'3", 200-pound guard. Here's footage of my highlights and my workout for the day. What's up, guys? This is me, your boy, Justin Taylor, also known as Jay Hood, also known as The Prophecy, but
Let's just face it, y'all don't really want to know my first name, so I'm just calling myself the Prophecy from now on. It's just so that I don't get my feelings hurt, because I know that you don't really want to hear my first name. Whatever. Anyways, what's up? This is the November edition of Questions and Answers with your boy, and guess what? Today's theme is a good one. You got Harlem Shake versus Gangnam Style. Let's get to it. I only got one question, and one question only for these heavyweight contenders. Yeah, you know where this is going. Which one is better, the Harlem Shake or Gangnam Style?
Gangnam Style, Gangnam Style. 낮에는 따사로운 인간적인 여자, 커피 한 잔에 여유를 아는 품격 있는 여자. 밤이 오면 심장이 뜨거워지는 여자, 그런 반전 있는 여자. 너는 선호해, 낮에는 너만큼 따사로운 그런 선호해. 커피 식기도 전에 원샷 때리는 선어해. 밤이 오면 심장이 터져버리는 선어해. 그런 선어해. 아름다워 사랑스러워
골로 테러리스타
Can do the Harlem Shake.
Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style. Op, 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 op. Op an Gangnam Style.
They do the Harlem Shake.
Op an Gangnam Style. Gangnam Style.
Transformation.
Kick in my
Harlem
Earthquake. I mean, you had the Harlem Shakers over here stomping the yard. You got the Gangnam Style over here burning stuff down and stuff like that. It was intense. It was intense. You even had some stinking leg people in there. I don't know what they had to do with it, but it was in there anyways. But yeah. This will be happening every November. I will try to find dance styles from the old to the new and put them against each other. Which one will come out on top? Hopefully next November we will find out. But anyways, this is your boy, Justin Taylor, also known as The Prophecy, also known as Reaper. No. I will see you next time.
This is Sonic Newz for November of 2013. Tonight's headlines include woman getting behind horrific Trayvon Martin costume gets fired from her job. Oh, Edwin Torbaca, whoever the heck he is sentenced for 11 months for having sex with a pumpkin in a pool raft, apparently. Oh. People in Australia think naked rugby is a great thing to bring back, and much, much more. But first, tonight's panel, we have on our panel tonight, BJ, Dizzy to the Joe, Chris Tizzall, and Rashid. Now our regulars, Alex Bradbury will be here in a second, and LG could not be here tonight due to circumstances beyond his control. All right, but let's get to what we like to do all the time, is just making fun of these headlines because we're that ruthless. You know what I mean? First. Women behind horrific Trayvon Martin costume gets fired from a job. Now, I know some probably have heard of this headline. Some may have not. Now, I seen the picture, and I probably will share it with you guys in a second. But the headline reads like this: to mom who thought it was cool for her kids to dress up like Trayvon Martin and George Zimmerman for Halloween, we glad karma has come back to bite her in the butt. According to different sources, and they were all valid, by the way, y'all, Caitlin Cimino has been fired from her job for posting racially intensive photos of her sons, William and Greg, with the caption, "Happy Halloween from Zimmerman and Trayvon." Now, the Massachusetts woman failed to realize that you could be easily tracked down if you post your full name or photo. If you full name your photos of your children at school, shots of your car with the license plates, and selfies. Duh. After one Instagram user wrote, "You ruined your life by posting these pics," quote unquote. Caitlin quickly changed her profile name and deleted the racist shots. However, it was too late. Because according to the Facebook page, Stop Blackface for Halloween, earlier this morning, quote unquote, Caitlin had her employer listed on her Facebook page, but recently deleted it. Members of the Tumblr community took note of the employer before the deletion and contacted them to report the incident. Around 12:54 p.m., they called the employer to report the incident and has stated that she has been fired. As Kevin Hart would put it bluntly, she learned today. Or she learned that day. Now, here's my thing on that. First, I'm cheesed off about this matter, right? Mm-hmm. Well, I cheesed off at the topic because stuff like that you're not supposed to make fun of. I don't care. I don't care who it is. This Trayvon Martin and Zimmerman thing, that's something that I wouldn't even make light of or whatnot. Mm-hmm. But the female in this case, I'll make fun of her. let me tell you something. First, let me start off with the basics. First, you're talking about, okay, you're posting up pictures on your Tumblr, your Facebook, MySpace for those who have it. But the number one thing is, say for example, you're calling out of work. Okay. You say, oh, I'm sick. I'm gonna be sick for the next couple of days or whatever. But you sit here, post up a picture of you and your kids in Disney World on Instagram. What do you think is gonna happen? You're gonna be gone. You're gonna be done.
Yo, Carly.
That's good.
Yo, Carly.
Hey, jump in.
All right. Now this next story that I'm going to come up with, this is amazing. Just listen to this one. Boston gangster James Whitey Bulger gets life in prison. Former mob boss whose story inspired Scorsese film The Departed, guilty of 11 murders. 11 murders. That's a lot.
Oh, what?
I saw this thing here on WBC on CBS just today. Wow. Let me tell you about this thing here. And this article came from CBC.ca. All right?
Oh, this is the Canada channel.
That's right. I'm Canadian. And listen to what they have to say on this James Whitey Bulger thing. Convicted mob boss James Whitey Bulger will spend the rest of his life in prison after a U.S. judge on Thursday sentenced him to serve 2 life terms plus 5 years for crimes he committed, including 11 murders. The scope, the callousness, the depravity of your crimes are almost unfathomable, U.S. District Judge Denise Casper told Bulger, 84, who was convicted in August on charges including racketeering, extortion, drug dealing, and other crimes as he ran Boston's Winter Hill crime gang in the 1970s and 80s. Bulger stood silently wearing an orange prison jumpsuit over a long-sleeve t-shirt as his sentence was read. Attorneys for Bulger decided to speak on his behalf at the 2-day sentencing hearing, saying their client had instructed them not to participate in a proceeding he viewed as a sham. A sham, I say. Yeah, it's that bad, isn't it? After a two-month trial, Bulger was found guilty of 31 of 32 criminal counts. Boy, that narrows it down, doesn't it? Including 11 of 19 murders prosecuted had accused him of committing. Bulger's trial was raw, broken by outbursts in which former gangmates turned prosecution witnesses swore at the man who lived on the lam for 16 years. Now, let's talk about the processing film that we were talking about earlier. During Thursday's hearing, he spoke only once, replying, yes, when Casper asked if he understood he had a right to appeal the verdict. Bulger's story has captivated the city's residents for years. He rose from a South Boston housing project to become the most fierce person in the city at the same time that his brother, William, became the powerful president of the state senate. His life inspired Martin Scorsese's 2006 Academy Award-winning film, The Departed. The testimony of human suffering that you and your associates inflicted on others was at times agonizing to hear and painful to watch, Casper said. At times during the trial, I wish that we were watching a movie, that we were...
What? At times during the trial, Wait. You need to watch the movie. Was that boring?
Yeah. At times during the trial, I wish that we were watching a movie that we were hearing was not real. This guy got what he wanted. And here's something that came all, here's a story that go all the way back to 1953. We have a mugshot of James Whitey Bulger. A 1953 Boston police booking photo shows him after an arrest. Bulger was the reigning gangster of the Boston criminal underworld at one time and spent 16 years on the lam. After his arrest in 2011, he was tried and convicted of extortion, drug dealing, and murder and was sentenced to a two-day hearing ending Thursday. Boston Police Associated Press has said. What? What a story. What a story.
Yeah, I'm so glad somebody played that.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
I am so glad somebody played that.
Right today. I couldn't.
I wanna know why they went so far. Why they went so far just for a two-day sit? That doesn't.
So, I know how you feel.
That's just like say I committed a murder tomorrow. And I don't get convicted for it until about 40 years later. Then I just get a slap on the wrist for 5 days.
Yeah, pretty much. All right. Well,
somebody jump
ready
in.
Ready for the King of Ratchets? I'm kidding. That's not me. I'm not that.
World star.
But I'm livening it up a little bit. Actually, what I wanted to talk about was something I actually just skimmed across. Didn't do too much research. I mean, because it's probably false, but the pretense itself is good enough for me. So apparently, they say it's false, but I just want to talk about this anyway. Apparently, some guy sued his wife for being ugly and him having he sued her. Yeah, right? You heard about that, right?
Yeah.
And I saw a new one where he sued his wife and he's suing her for the kids being ugly. And I saw the photo and I'm not gonna lie, I was kinda like, those kids are kinda rough. Just a little bit. But I was just curious, like, what are the steps taken to decide, okay, yeah, they ugly, or no, they're all right, they're not that bad.
It's the ratio. The eyes are bigger than your teeth, and
I'm one of those people.
Wait a minute, say that again, Dizzy?
I said, I'm sure that they had, like, good personality.
They probably have, like a board, and it's like, okay, I'm about to say something extremely racist, I'm sorry. They probably have, like, a board of what most Asian individuals look like, and they probably just hold it up next to them, and if you don't reach that quota, then... Nah, bruh.
He's like Asian, not Asian.
You ugly. Oh, no, he's not. He's not Asian enough. Sorry. He's ugly. All right, you win. And I wonder how much he would have got if the case were real.
You know, it's funny that because the last two was talking about.
Oh, you gonna have to bring that back. We can't hear you. You gonna have to bring it back.
Wait a minute, say it again. You're breaking up, bro.
Can you hear me?
Okay, yeah. There we go.
Yeah, I said, you know, the Hudge twins was talking about like they was having a contest about who's the most ugliest.
I saw that video. Hey, that dude was darker.
Yes.
I'm dark, but he was like Rock. Yeah. He was like my work bag type stuff. Like,
but do you think? But do you think that he was ugly? But do you think that he was ugly than the family?
Oh man, see, but he was so dark, and they were Asian. I don't even know. there are two different worlds. That's like comparing like. I don't even know. That's like comparing Pokemon and like Beyblade. Like you can't do it. Same concept, different stuff. You know what I mean? Like you can't do it. That dude was ugly.
Let it rip.
Y'all.
Oh God, that was just horrible. That's horrible.
I got another news that I want to discuss about. It's about the population of Japan. It seems that the women over there are not, you know, helping the repopulation due to the fact that they want to do the boost their careers and stuff like that. Like, what are your guys' thoughts on that?
They're not helping with the population. You know what that means.
We
all know what that means. Like,
seriously. I need to stop playing on that.
Yeah.
And on X, just by looking at my face, I think you know what.
Exactly. Yo. Yeah. Like, sorry, honey. Work is tough. I cannot help with the population tonight.
Nope. Like, I got a headache.
I got a headache.
I'm back. Yeah, headache.
No populating for me.
I have a migraine.
I got Xbox. I got an Xbox game to play.
Oh snap! That would be just crazy.
No, but you know, it wouldn't be as shocking if it happened over here, though.
Yeah.
You said it wouldn't be as shocking if it happened over here. Yeah, you're absolutely right. Let that happen over here in the States, it'll be just another day in the ballpark. it's just that crazy.
Yeah.
Well, let's go on to the next headline, which is
the next headline is I didn't mean to cut you off, but No Shave November.
Oh, you late. Homeboy BJ had already,
Why do I want to talk about something that I can't participate in? That's stupid. Let's talk about something else.
Yeah, but here's the thing. Did he talk about the women participating?
Y'all
want to talk about something, though. Look at this. I got nothing. I cannot participate in this. This does not make no sense to me.
Now you can get like one of those cold things, like Beardos. Have you ever heard of it?
Bro, yes, I have seen those. The mugs look kind of dope. I can't even lie.
Those are crazy, you know? Let's pick on Google for a second.
I was gonna talk about that, but I felt like somebody else is gonna do it, so I wanna get on it, you know? And then y'all were talking about it, and y'all like, why is everybody complaining? I know why everybody's complaining, because if I don't use Google Plus, which, I mean, Google Plus obviously is a success for us, but for everybody else who's already on Facebook, Twitter, everything else, Tumblr, like, Google Plus is not a necessity. And for Google to be like, look, man, we ain't banking like Facebook, all right? We ain't banking like Twitter, all right? So can y'all just try us out real quick? Like, just try us out, and then you could go back to your everyday life of commenting on YouTube. Just try us out. That's messed up.
I know.
Because everybody's not on Google Plus like that, bro. And like, honestly, if I wasn't just trying to expand YouTube wise, I wouldn't be on Google Plus like that either. Do I like Google Plus? Yes, because to me it's a hybrid of Twitter and Facebook. But let's be real here. Google Plus is not really that successful.
But that's the thing. It's one of those things that you'll hear about Facebook in a movie. Everybody knows Facebook.
Exactly.
Google Plus is just some.
Like, yeah, you can be like, hey, what's your Facebook? And 9 times out of 10, they'll be like, oh, exactly. Yeah, blah, 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 blah. Yeah. Hey, what's your Google Plus? What's my, huh?
Your Google Plus. Yeah, but that's not like such a hipster.
I'm glad that you brought up Google, because there was an article that I was reading is that, or even though I was watching it on SourceFed, they were talking about Google and having this, some type of tattoo that you can just put on your neck.
That's the one. Yeah, that was the one I was that was the one I was going to read. but I'm glad you brought that up, Chris, and I'm glad you brought that up, Dizzy.
Not to mention, one of the one of the co-founders of YouTube actually said it himself, that the new comment system sucks.
Yeah.
I think it's okay.
My brother. You know what he did?
Let me say something before then I'll let you.
I have a feeling something crazy. Go ahead.
No. It's gonna be simple.
I'm gonna let you finish. But the old YouTube system had one of the best commenting systems of all time.
I will say this. But there's something in like in Google Plus is they show you have that little notification that somebody that says that somebody shared your video or something.
Yeah.
That's a good feature, I guess.
Yeah, I mean it'd be making me feel good and stuff, but like I said, obviously everybody ain't on YouTube, so it benefits us. We're YouTubers. We do this. This is our life. We do this. But if you're not a YouTuber, you're just like, why do I need a Google Plus? I don't use the crap. I have a Facebook. Okay?
I think it's because they're trying to use it to stalk you even more. Or just try to get more information, more like Facebook.
Maybe, man.
You trying to make it at Facebook. Like, how about I don't even go on Google Plus?
I mean...
Speaking of which, let's get to this tattoo thing that Dizzy mentioned earlier. Now this is an article that I have from CNN, which states, it looks like Google Glass, for those who remember that, was just the beginning. Google now appears to be aiming a few inches lower. The neck, I mean. Google-owned Motorola Mobility has filed for a patent published last week for a system that compromises an electronic skin tattoo capable of being applied to the throat region of a body. The patent says that the tattoo will communicate with smartphones, gaming devices, tablets, and wearable tech like Google Glass via a Bluetooth-style connection, and would include a microphone and power source. That sounds in the movie, doesn't
First of all, I'm going to get a little crazy. First of all, I already got, all I need is just touching my damn screen on my phone, so that I don't need those freaking tattoos to try to communicate with my damn phone.
That's the thing. It's one of those things, you say that now, because I would say that as well. But you know now they've got watches, where you can control your phone and everything from your watch. But then, a few years ago, there wasn't even anything like Bluetooth. So,
that
may get to a point where that's normal, and everybody's like, oh, I'm getting a call, hold up. Reception.
Right. Hey, you see my new tattoo? Like, how'd you get it, Google? I'm like, oh.
Hold on, I gotta take my turtleneck off. Hold on, Mom. My turtleneck's too tight. Hold on. I can't hear you.
I was like, girl, I like your turtleneck, but what's that tattoo?
You know that Thai calling thing where you accidentally call somebody and your phone's in your pocket? And this one, you call someone, you're like, no, I was scratching, my bad. I didn't realize. Yeah.
Hope you got insurance. If you scratch it off, that's a wrap.
They said it's temporary, even though I don't trust it.
Now, reading this thing here, I'm reading this article a little bit more, and I come to this paragraph that catches my eye, and it reads, optionally, the electronic skin tattoo can further include a galvanic skin response detector to detect skin resistance of a user. The 10-page document reads, even though they shorten it up a lot, it is contemplated that a user may being nervous or engaging in speaking falsehoods may exhibit different galvanic skin response than a more confident truth-telling individual. So Google, what are you trying to say? This thing is going to be like a lie detector?
A lie detector, exactly.
First of all, the only thing that can be resistant for my skin is lotion, baby oil, sunscreen, and anything other than that. But
yeah,
no, but lie detector, that's just like your girlfriend. That's like your girlfriend trying to find out if you're cheating or not. You know, that's... You don't need all this much information.
Yeah.
Babe, who that girl? Then why your tattoo glowing? Why your tattoo glowing?
I see right now that if Google actually do go through this, I see it right now. All the women's going to be like, hey, what? Hey,
no, what's you know, it's funny that if you look on YouTube right now, and if you look up, type up electronic tattoo, you'll show up.
Yeah, but I guarantee you, all the women are going to be like, I want you to wear this tattoo right now.
And I can guarantee you, all the ratchet females that don't trust nobody going to be single.
Mm-hmm.
You're right.
Period, point blank.
No, this is from a very wise man that once said, and his name was Young Yo.
Now, see, people, Google are trying to put people like Maury out of business.
No, he already out of business. Yes, I said it.
Oh. Ooh, ouch. Ouch.
Look, he already had too many baby mamas, all right?
And speaking from the UK perspective, that would put people like Jeremy Cowell out of business.
Nah, somebody big boned needs to be fighting on the show anyway. So you know.
Yeah, we need someone better than Jeremy Cowell anyway. He's a whole lot.
Yeah, somebody has to be the. Somebody needs to beat the. Who else gonna beat the Wendy Williams show? I'm just saying.
Oh, I mean, God.
I don't watch it, bro.
Oh.
She needs to get off the air. Like, immediately.
Everything. Like.
Ew. I can't even brought it there. That's. No.
I can't even say if she's a she or not. A lot of people saying she's a he.
Why'd you put the S in front of him?
Yeah. All of people saying that Wendy's a he, so I don't know.
I believe it. That's why I don't watch it.
I'm getting this.
Lady Gaga is the Illuminati.
I got it.
Right. All right. Okay. Wait. So we're just throwing out topics, right?
Yeah. You got okay, one to so jump in with?
I've got one.
Oh, right. Jump in.
So, now get this. Somebody like these. I think they were brothers or whatever. They were just mucking around in their room. They play fighting. And one throws the other one at a bookcase. He hits the bookcase. The bookcase opens up and reveals a stairway in his house that they've been living in. It reveals the staircase. They go down that staircase and they find a hidden room in their house where there's like blankets, there's food that had gone missing from the house. Carved, there's a like a carving of an elephant and toy dog. Mad.
Hmm. Okay, so
that doesn't sound like a good Google Hangout.
Now this person had been coming up, so you know all those times when you're sitting there, this is all you can back me up on this, and you think that there are three more Oreos and there's only two, and you're like, where'd the other one go?
Oh no. You were not supposed to be living in my house for more than 10 minutes.
I will know.
Forget 10 minutes, be 5 seconds.
But then, that's the thing, how long was that guy there? The funny thing is what, I also heard a similar story to this 2 years ago when this woman went into her attic one day and they found out her ex-boyfriend had gotten out of prison and had been living in her attic for the past year or so.
He just wants some prison coochie. He just wants some prison coochie. That's all. That's lame. Yeah.
But that's an elaborate way to go for it. You could knock on the door. You know?
Bruh. I feel like, honestly, if you are unaware enough to the fact that somebody can live in your house that long without you knowing, you deserve everything you got coming. No food, being broke, your electric bill being unnecessarily high, can't find your favorite underwear. I don't care. You deserve it.
I see right now people open up the thing and be like, $600?
Yeah, exactly.
I'm not that exactly. Wait a minute.
Well, you know what I was thinking as well is you can see in your house when walls don't match up. So you can see that, okay, this side of the door is the dining room, and then this side is a bedroom. So how is it that there's some big areas, big space, and they don't
right.
Know? Yeah, you know?
Hey, who left the lump in my wall?
Crazy.
You know, speaking of prison, for some odd reason, it's
you're running out of prison bus cells for people.
You look like you're about to bust a freestyle.
Yeah, true.
Michael,
tell me my face, about to spit some real stuff. This YouTube money hard, life is getting rough.
Come on, I'm sweating.
They're not ready. She ain't twerking.
They not ready.
Oh,
and she can't stop. Hope she will stop.
Oh God.
True. Miley Cyrus, like after that thing, that kind of like you know amazed me because she's different.
She has gone crazy.
I'm just gonna be that guy and just say it. I'm just gonna be that guy and say it. I don't care. Miley Cyrus can get the business. I don't care. I don't care. I hate her actions, and I hate the dumb stuff she does, but I don't care. She can get it. I don't care. And this is coming from a virgin. I don't care.
Oh, wow.
Miley's swinging on his wrecking ball.
I don't care. Exactly.
I hope you didn't see the one with, what's his name? Like the parody of the one wrestler.
What was that?
I know what you're talking about. Dang it! I can't think of the name, but I know what he's talking about though. That was
Hulk Hogan.
What was that?
Hulk Hogan.
Yeah, okay. That's it. That yikes. That was horrific. That was just cool. Yep. Like who put that on the internet? Like, we don't want to see that.
What, his tape?
Huh?
His tape?
Oh, yeah, I heard about that, yeah.
Yeah.
Yo, speaking of that, did you hear about Batista's daughter?
Batista?
Her?
Batista's daughter. Had
oh, tape. Is she bad? I'm about to Google her right now.
Batista's
daughter had a sex tape with her boyfriend. Imagine the bravery of this guy. That's Batista's daughter.
Hold on.
Batista daughter scandal?
I'm gonna type this down and I hope everybody laughs. I don't wanna see.
Oh God! Is this her? Oh God!
Oh God!
Oh! Oh!
Amen, brother.
Wait. Is a bird. Lord.
So do I have to go over there and hose you down with a fire extinguisher?
Nope. When I have a daughter, I'm going to beat her ugly. It's all good. Oh. You don't have to worry about none of this.
It depends on why you're whooping her. Like,
The minute I find out my daughter is gorgeous, I'm throwing her, like, off a truck or something. I don't know. She has to be ugly.
Why? Why are you so...
Because having a pretty daughter is just too much. It's too much.
Too much work. Too much work.
Right? Because, like, you being a guy, she's going to bring a dude home, and she'll be like, Daddy, this is my boyfriend. You're going to be like, yo, what? How long you know this dude?
I would be surprised if my daughter bring a dude home, like, where is he from? Like, just ask questions about, like, he could be, like, any kind of dude. He could be nice or whatever, but if he wanted to get up on a nigga in my house, I'd be like, hell no, you better get up on a
nigga. What would you do
see,
if your
see,
daughter...
but look.
But what if your daughter was dating a girl? What would you do?
that's a different story. That's a different story.
I don't know about that.
How is that different?
Because we live in America. No, because standards.
Because biologically,
black people still live in Africa.
Like, it's not going too much into it, but biologically, if your daughter has a boyfriend and they're extremely friendly, biologically, that's a little bit invasive. Like, if you think about it, your pure daughter has been invaded, like, American, and you're just there, and you're like,
see, that's another thing. I don't ever want to know. Daddy, exactly. I'm pregnant. Daughter, you're homeless.
You better be 21.
You know what's funny? I bet everybody would be like having a conversation like that girl in that one bar, like how the hell do you have to get this up?
The what?
Have you seen that one bar?
Yeah.
About the girl who accidentally sucked the
truth.
Yeah. Accidentally?
Yeah.
Like, I have to bring something to everybody's attention. I just read what Dizzy put in the chat. I know those of you in the archives are not going to see the chat, but he asked.
He's saying it, not me.
I'm gonna read exactly what I'm reading in this chat, and the question was asked.
would you
want to see Will and Jada sex tape? And answer. Yeah,
it would be hilarious.
Oh no.
It would be hilarious.
I'm gonna say no just because no. I find sex tapes really weird. But
oh,
Jada could get it. Tis all.
No, but that would be hilarious though, because you imagine Will Smith. Like, yeah.
Not to mention they are swingers.
Nah, I think that's a rumor.
Have you seen that?
And West Philadelphia, born and raised. After the Matrix, I'm doing Jada in this place.
You see, Ray J and what's her name? And Kardashian.
Man, that's
guess what, guys? Guess what? I got a secret I gotta tell you.
What's that secret?
Kim Kardashian is getting pregnant again. Because Kanye West is having a girl instead of a boy.
What?
I didn't know about that.
You're getting pregnant again.
I don't think that's a rumor. Maybe.
Because she sent him. Did you see that one on, what is it, she tagged him on Instagram or something?
Oh, yeah, actually, I saw that on, like, one of those magazines on the store. On the rack next to the gum, next to the tape, and stuff.
Yeah. He was like, I'm coming home, honey.
Big said also.
Yeah.
No new friends.
Now I got a hilarious headline for you guys. Now, for those of you out there who like to watch the Trisha Goddard show, please turn away from your screen now or just skip ahead. But on November 18th, there's going to be a special show. On November 18th, which is on a Monday, there's going to be a special show, and it's going to be it's going to be a white supremacist up there. However, wait! Before anyone judges,
white power.
There's going to be a black woman with her, and what the black woman is going to brought him on the show to prove is his DNA. To prove to him that he got some black in him or whatnot. Now I'm fixing to play a little bit of this story. Because I got this on video. Now I want you to listen in on this.
VHS tapes.
Oh, wait a minute. Well, after this commercial that's playing right now.
Can't believe it. And it comes back later in the day, which proves it went away.
Hold on.
That must not be for niggas.
Hold on, let me refresh the page.
I'm good, I'm not a nigga.
What?
Ten points.
Okay. I'm gonna bring back the audio after it finishes. After it finishes the commercial, I don't know why it does it every time I come here. But once you listen to this, it's gonna be very, very hilarious. I'm telling you, it was like the dude couldn't believe it himself. Okay, 5, 4. Okay, it's about to come up right about now.
Does anybody remember the legendary Dave Chappelle skit where Chappelle plays the black KKK leader? You know, at the end of the skit, he finds out that he was actually black. Well, that kind of happened in real life, except the white supremacist we're talking about, he's not even blind. Check this out.
Craig Paul Cobb has undergone DNA testing to determine genetic ancestry. 86% European. And,
Give it to him.
14% sub-Saharan African.
Totally, I heard enough. Let's talk about it.
But yeah, this is a white supremacist who thought he was 100%, basically 100% white, but comes to find out he's 86% and 14% black.
Good.
I would have something to say about it. Because I really do have mixed feelings about this.
What?
I mean, I don't have that much mixed feelings about it, but... Okay, at first, when I first heard about this, I was thinking about, okay, this is another media propaganda kind of bullcrap trying to make white people black people. Or trying to make some sense in the Negro world. But, on the other hand, there is some type of way that, you know, some white folks are descendants of black people from Africa.
This is what I gotta say about this thing. Like, for him to be brought on national TV, right, and get proven by DNA, and as we all know, DNA don't lie, that he is 14% sub-Saharan African. I wish I could have seen the video. Like, he didn't want to accept the fact that he was, because it kind of reminds you of that on Dave Chappelle skit where he was like black power, thinking that he was white, but he was blind and he didn't know.
Yeah. But the thing is, though, like, if you think about it, it never actually works out for the better finding out that you're part of what you hate. Because if you think about it, Hitler was a Jew, Darth Vader was a Jedi, Loki was a demon. You know, it's like, it's all, it's never going to really help out, because he's probably going to end up worse now.
Chris is always a college student. I mean, yeah, it's just craziness.
That right there, that was just really crazy.
So who wants to come with me and try to hang this nigga?
Whoa!
Hey! So if they can't say the N word, I can say this.
Press the button.
You know what? You know what though? That's what I encourage on my show. Pressing red buttons, and I give Dizzy kudos for that, because he's the first one in a while that pushes that red button. No, actually, you're the second one. The first one was last month by Mr. Tizall over here. Because remember that Oreo story you brought up last night, and you showed the cookie.
I like that.
Yeah, I like that one.
Willie, was it that one Oreo about the one with the spider in it?
Yeah, that's it.
Oh no, I didn't bring that story up, but you know, whatever. I'll eat that. I'll go in on that. I ain't scared.
Oh, okay. So let me ask you a question. Would you eat the one with the one they had the big debate about, the one with the gay rice, the one with the rainbow?
I actually never saw that, but honestly, I'm not really into, like, fruity stuff. Like, my chocolates have nothing to do with fruits. Like, fruits and chocolates should stay separate, except for when it's, like, a chocolate fountain. You know, you got the strawberries, and you can look bad for the girls at prom. Like, they be standing there, and they dressing and stuff, and you get your little strawberry. You be looking at them with the chocolate, like... You go dead.
She got you up.
That's the only
night.
Exception.
No.
Exactly.
Eating chocolate and strawberries. She got you up.
Other than that, yeah, man. Like, no, I've never tried anything fruity. And if you don't watch my channel, then you don't know. But all I eat is peanut butter Oreos. I have my variety, but peanut butter Oreos is the banana. If you don't like those, then I don't like you.
Have you ever ate it with Nutella?
Why would I do that? What's
wrong with that? Who is that?
Oh, that's me. Sorry, that's mine. Sorry.
Oh, some Power Rangers.
Speaking of Power Rangers, no, I'm not even gonna do that. I'm not even gonna do that.
You mean
the Power Rangers or the Fruity Brigade?
Whoa! Did you just say
that?
Obviously, somebody's not on my channel. That. A line was crossed.
Wait a minute, he's on another network.
I can explain.
I was the
Blue Ranger for Halloween.
And I think your brother was.
Oh, wait, hold on, Crib all day.
Call me Fruity?
No, I didn't. You say if you was a Blue Ranger, you'd die.
So you've had a bite of me because I'm Fruity, and you know?
I guess so. I must have enjoyed.
So now who's Fruity? See, that's the question. Who's Fruity?
I mean, you know. Sometimes you have that blueberry that I like. You know, I'm just.
If you know how I taste, I mean, what
is going on
here? Messed up.
This has. We went from news to what? WTF news?
What the fuck, man?
I gotta say this. What do you guys? Okay, hold on. Would you ever get the Nintendo 3DS?
No.
Would I ever get one? I mean,
just based on the design? No.
Yeah, I know.
I mean, I have a bunch of friends who have it. So, I mean, whatever. Me personally, I feel like gaming is dead to an extent. Let's hear him out. I already knew y'all were going to say that. Like, I already knew everybody's going to react like that. I don't mean gaming's dead. Like, oh.
Okay,
I don't mean like Gamey's dead, like, oh, Gamey is so gay. No. I mean, look, we're on the fourth gen, right?
Right.
We're on the fourth gen. The gap, the awe and oh my damn and Lord Jesus, look at these graphics. The gap is like this big. Like, the difference between third gen systems and fourth gen systems is an Instagram filter. That's it. that's we're basically playing the same systems again, but with like slight differences. And it's like, okay, gamers, like developers, they're trying, yes. But it's like, what more can you add? You need to stop focusing on graphics and start focusing on features, which, believe it or not, it's not even a big deal anymore. Like, they're still like, hey, we need to make these graphics look good. Look, you can see the chin hairs on this nigga. Look, it doesn't look like a little line on paint. Like, bro, I don't care about that. Because I look at it like this. You can make a game that looks real as hell, like this conversation right here. But if that game was strictly me walking around, knocking on doors, being a door-to-door salesman, I'm not going to play that ish. I don't want to play it. Why? Because the features are boring. It's a dumb game. The replay value sucks.
See, here's the reason why. I think it's because of not a lot of people are because they never know our generations of games, knowing the improvement of the years during the maybe like the mid 90s to the 2000s.
I mean, because look, what's crazy is me and my brother, right? Mm-hmm. We just bought a PS2. Because gameplay back in the day was like this, like up there. Nowadays, we give games more credit than they deserve because the graphics are good. We're like, oh, dang, these graphics are so tight. But it's like most of the games we get nowadays on a new gen, you beat it and you're like, all right, well, that game was tight.
Well, let's go on to the next game.
But I'm never going to play it again. But I bet you if we were all sitting in a room right now and I popped in Mario Kart 64, we'll all start playing that shit for hours. Yeah.
No, Super Smash Brothers. That would be more.
That too!
Oh man, yes. Mario Party.
You know what? Exactly. You showed it to me. It's like, when I see people, when I played Call of Duty for the first time, I never really got into it, but then I'd go back and play the old GoldenEye.
Yes, bro, that game is the business.
Man, people be feeling that game like it was nothing.
And see, look, and this is what I'm talking about. You would go back and play that game, right? But if you notice on multiplayer, when you kneel down on your knees, they're sliding like this. So we don't care because the game's fun. Who cares? Yeah. It's funny. It doesn't make sense, but the game works. Yet you still play it. Now we got all these new games where they actually move their legs, but you don't play it as much because it's not as fun.
But yeah, speaking of games, like, who got to GTA 5? Grandfather
5. Man, let's not talk about that. How is it?
I didn't play it. My brother bought it. It looks tight, though. I played it a few times. It's pretty dope.
This is my take on GTA 5. And this is my take on GTA 5, like, and this is probably going to support Chris's theory even more. I have people to hit me up about this game, like, oh, do I got it? And I tell them, no, I'm going to wait until I get the PS4 to get it. You know, kind of lie and say that I'm going to get the game even though I'm not going to get the game. I am going to get the PS4, but not the game. Anyway.
Why you got to lie, though? Yeah.
You ain't gotta lie, Craig.
But the point is this: majority of those people, I say about 95% of those people that hit me up and said, "Oh, I got the new GTA 5," have beat the game in 2 days or less. Matter of fact, one of them told me that they had beat the game in about like 5 or 6 hours. They played it nonstop.
Okay.
Something like, why would you play it that long?
But the thing is, the thing about GTA 5 is like, that's one of those games that actually falls into the category that I'm talking about. It actually has a lot of features. Like, they focused on stuff that matters. And I actually saw like an article, and it was like small things, small details in GTA. It was like 5 small details that you wouldn't have noticed. And it's like they actually took time and put effort into that game. They didn't beat the game, obviously, because they obviously don't know that online actually has a co-op kind of campaign thing, too, online that you can do, which me and my brother actually plan on doing, too. They didn't beat shit. They just scratched the iceberg. Just the tip of the iceberg.
Yeah, true. That's another thing that I noticed. Like, you notice, like, on these multiplayer shooter games or whatever, you notice people go directly to the multiplayer, but don't think about playing the story mode.
It depends on which game you're talking about. If it's Battlefield, yes. If it's Call of Duty, no. Call of Duty, I normally play the story first because they actually try on their stories. Battlefield is kind of like, well, whatever. I'll play it when I get bored.
Yeah, like, I don't really like Battlefield, but it doesn't.
I didn't like Battlefield because I only played it once, and then when my brother bought it and I played it, I was like, damn. Because the difference between Battlefield and Call of Duty is more arcade feels. It's fast. Boom, 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 boom. Battlefield is slightly more tactical, and you don't care as much about your KD. You get 3 kills, and you feel like Jesus, because those kills are amazing, and then it's so realistic, crazy stuff that you never thought would happen, which is why their tagline, only in Battlefield, works. You can't say no shit like only in Call of Duty, because, let's be real, Call of Duty doesn't have that many amazing things that can happen that you won't see 5 billion at one time. Yes, there are going to be some amazing across-the-map tomahawks or knives, but there's plenty of knife montages on YouTube where you start to expect it. Like, that's regular now. Instead of being like 1 in 1,000,000, it's more like 1 in 1,000 now, you know? Battlefield?
I see that more. It's just like rehashes of the same exact thing.
One more time?
All the Call of Duty games, from what I've seen of them, they all seem to be rehashes of the same game. Like, there might be a variation of the whole effort.
And that is what everybody says, but that's not necessarily true. And the problem is, people who follow Call of Duty don't really follow it. Like, everybody's, like, tripping, like, oh, they don't have this, whatever, whatever. What people fail to realize is it's more of a every other year. Black Ops was made by Treyarch.
Right.
And the Call of Duty that just came out was made by Infinity Ward. Those are the guys behind Modern Warfare and all that stuff. Black Ops is Treyarch, which is why the one that just came out doesn't have zombies. But you see, they tried to create their own game mode that's kind of like zombies, because Treyarch only has 2 games. But they are shitting on Modern Warfare. Like, Black Ops 2 came out, and then Modern Warfare 3 just... Modern Warfare what? And to an extent, you're right. But they still do create new game modes, kind of. And it's really just, to each his own. Because I could say the same thing about Madden or FIFA. You know what I mean?
I've said the same thing about Madden and FIFA. I see it as the same thing. One will look more, like you were saying, I can see the beard hairs on this guy. That's crazy.
Right. And it's like, what features do you have?
Yeah, just like when Fight Night came around, that's how I was thinking the same thing. I was like, wow, it's kind of getting more realistic.
You know what they need? They
need to make games like for 3D glasses. Because they could actually like... ingrown hair out you. Yeah. But the thing that I think what's missing in games, at least for me, is that they don't have that collide no more. At least, I don't know, I guess I played a different kind of games. It's like when you play like a Dragon Ball, you feel like you can do like a big rush. Just like collide, you know,
Have any of you played Bioshock?
I tried, but my a friend of mine's kept coming to my house and playing it, so I couldn't enjoy it. Cause every time I would come home, this nigga was in my room playing my games, and I'm like, I just got home from school, like, what the hell? But I didn't say anything about it. He killed Assassin's Creed for me. He killed BioShock for me. And some other stuff. I was just like, you know what? This is gay. I'm never going to play BioShock because of you.
That game is like what you were saying, the old generation games were fun. That is amazing.
I know BioShock's amazing, though, because it has all those features and stuff, like powers, guns, like everything you would want in a game.
You know the thing, you know the one game that should really more advance in this generation more?
What's that?
And don't be all, you know, spazzed out. I think Pokemon needs to be more physical, more, at least in the Pokemon Stadium.
What? I'm sorry, I mean, more realistic. Because I don't play Pokemon, but I've seen the shit that people have to go through just to get certain types, and I'm like, nope, not doing it.
That's too much work.
Like, Pokemon is it's way too complex now. It's 3D now. That's dope. But it's just like my friend, he's constantly posting on Facebook. Like, they have, bro, Pokemon has gotten so serious that they have pages, like, legit pages to find certain types of Pokemon and trade with people you don't know so you can get the ones that you want. Whatever happened to, man, what you find is what you get, and when you finally do find the one you're looking for, it's like, oh, Jesus, thank you, Lord. No, not even that anymore. He's like, look, his dad is...
Work to it.
All of a sudden, there's 150, then all of a sudden, oh my gosh, there's 151. What? Then there was a clone of another one. Oh my god, there's 152. Now, I don't even know
how to play. Gotta catch him all. Gotta catch him.
You can't catch them all. You keep making more.
Like, his status.
Exactly.
Because, like, we all watch the hot things through his status, his last status update. I'm hatching all kinds of eggs right now. Hashtag lady hunting. Hashtag Pokemon X and Y. Oh, rain team completed. Next up, sun. I'll just wait on a bank to get my hail and sandstorm team. Man, I miss Pokegen.
Better drink.
All these non-shiny Pokemon hatching makes me feel some type of way. When I get out of class, I'm about to hatch me all kinds of eggs.
Wow.
It goes on forever. And this one's funny because his mom commented on it. She was like, study. He's like, hi, Mom. And then my friend was like, hi, Mom. And then my other friend was like, hi, Mom. And then our other friend was like, hi, Miss Johnson. And our other friend was like, hi, Mom. And I was like, hey, Mom. So, yeah.
Yeah.
But, yeah, Pokemon's too damn complex now.
On this topic of news thing, is that, like, this is completely backwards, but you reminded me when you were saying his mom commented. Right, so, there's this woman, right? Now, imagine, like, let's just say, put yourself in this position. This is your girlfriend, right? This woman.
Okay, which position?
Oh.
Beetle!
Time to show. Yeah, so, this woman, she's super paranoid to the point where, you know, she's like really, really jealous. Then she found out she was diagnosed with something called Othello's disease or something, or Othello's paranoia, where you're just constantly envious of everyone. But then since she was diagnosed, now she takes it to extremes because it's an actual thing. So now every time her boyfriend leaves the house and comes back, she makes him take a lie detector. Okay, where you been? Who you talking to? What's happened?
Okay, I'm sorry to cut you off.
That's what I'm talking to.
But that just brings me to this most ridiculous music video that I ever saw in my life that I actually saw on Tosh. And
just because
the title,
Justin Bieber was in it. Sorry.
The title of the song is "Smell Your Dick." Yes.
How do you go?
Let me smell your. I was like,
every step I make, I'm gonna smell your
dick. I wanna smell your. I don't want to be that guy to play it, because that's going to show up in my YouTube search history, but...
And that's going to be on the video, too, so...
Yeah. Unless you want to push that red button. Come on.
Come on, Blue Power Ranger. I know you can do
press it.
Oh, God. I mean, it's so... Look, bro, this video has 3 million. 3 million.
Time to make a parody.
I don't know how.
Yeah, but like,
3 million.
Two things though. It's like one of them is how could you stay with somebody who makes you take a lie detector test every single time you meet, and then the second one is that how ridiculous is it that everything can be made a psychological condition if somebody
you should
just
be in a mental hospital.
No, but then it's like, and it's he's jealous.
Hey!
He did it!
Hey! I can't, bro. Like,
let me smell your twat.
Hard to lie. Bro, she's so serious too. The beat just picked up.
Oh man.
I have to stop this. Bro, y'all gotta see this music video. So ridiculous.
It's so true.
Niggas.
That was just crazy. You know?
We gotta do better, black people. We gotta do better.
Oh my gosh. And I
we will do better. When we give them $20 for a whole week, that's when they're gonna do better.
And I think on that note, we are going to wrap it up. But first,
we're not done yet.
But wait a second. before we wrap up this podcast, I will remind you, Sonic.
I don't care, Coley. I don't care. I don't care that it's due Monday. I really don't. I don't care. I know that's what you're gonna say. I don't care.
I said Sonic viewers have Sonic dad.
Hold up. I was gonna make the video, but then I got bored.
I remind you, Sonic Show viewers, that coming up next will be a special Sonic Games. Yes, the first time we're ever doing this, and we're gonna be over our new cast member, Jorge Hidago, of his new PlayStation 4. That's right after the break. But first I like to thank BJ. I like to thank who was the other person that was in here? Yeah, Rashid. Who
you're a horrible host. I'll be upset right now.
Who is that guy?
I'm trying to remember everybody who had left.
Why don't you write it down then?
Hey.
I don't got no time.
That's just my baby daddy.
Anyway, DJ Rashid, who was in here early, but he had to abruptly leave or whatever, unfortunately. So, you know, I thank y'all two for popping in here. LG, I wish you was in here, but unfortunately, he couldn't be here.
Man, he got a girlfriend. He's stuck.
You don't got to, I'm saying though, you don't got to lie, Coley. LG, you don't got to lie either. Just lie, I'm with my girl. Is that what he told you? You know, I think Coley's just trying to hurry up and leave so he can go be with his A team. We're obviously right. A team. Mm-hmm. Coley has another YouTube channel that we don't know about that is like hella subscribers.
Hey, Coley, let me
now y'all know my A team. Y'all
Coley, let me smell your channel.
You smell my channel. Really? Really dizzy.
It's better than smelling your nuts.
Coley.
Wow. You're just ratchet dizzy, you know that?
he got some slack. He got some slack.
He called you the R word. You gonna take that?
Yeah, you know, yeah, you know, I got a place for him, and it's right in Goldsboro, North Carolina. It's called Cherry Hospital. That's for the mentally insane. Just saying.
Nah, I've been there last week. I only took it for a vacation.
Well, I think it's another time. I think you need another time to go there. Make it about.
Kick me out.
No, they ain't.
They kicked me out because I was playing with the intents.
They would love you there. But for those in the room, I like to thank Mr. X, like in Disney to the show. I guest moderated IRAP Diaries, aka Prince Drizzy Dre. And
Drizzy Dre, check him out. Play it out on the motherfucking dark side.
His channel, along with everybody else's, will be in the description box below. Dude, Chris Dissolve, which he's always a delight to have in here. He just raves up the room every time we have to do this.
But he died.
Well, you know, the way my laugh account is set up, you know.
But yeah, I was trying to see Cole, like, am I in or not, or whatever. I was just saying.
Let him know, Coley! Let him know, Coley!
He got some
sass. He's up, fast.
He's up, my boy.
He had to take a shot for that one.
Yeah.
Coley. Put the Sunny D down. Put the Sunny D down.
What that ain't said? Sunny D. That Sunny drank.
Yeah. I'm drinking Bacardi and Coley. Yeah, that's what I'm drinking.
That's why Coley always gave his
advice.
Can you speak up a little louder, please?
That's why Coley gave the advice to Dairy Detours.
Everybody chill. Everybody chill. Everybody chill. Everybody chill. Everybody chill real quick.
Hold up. I ain't done yet.
Everybody chill real quick.
Hey, Chris has to pour.
So, you going to answer the question, Coley?
Are you in
the
show? My answer is you in for a trial run.
Don't you dare put your finger on your record button. Stop the record button.
There's a shout out.
You think you're ready to hang with the big leash? You think you're ready for this sauce? You think you're ready? You better come hard, because I already did my stuff last minute. You ready?
You think you're ready?
Ready?
Hey, yes, I'm you saying. Saying answer.
Oh, you mean me?
Get yes, you.
Oh, man, yeah, like whatever it tastes like, seriously, yeah.
Oh. He said he ain't scared. Well, guess what? I'm here, so you should be scared.
Wow.
I'm one of the darkest people in this show. There's only enough room for one dark guy, and I'm knocking all your other niggas off. Real talk.
Man, shut up. We all know that you've been to this before.
I'm on my Kendrick shit right now, that's all.
Oh, man. All right, we got to get out of here. Stand by for Sonic Games and coming up next. On
the real shit? Yeah. Where'd you get that jacket from?
We
I want a blue one. Members only?
We will see
y'all. The Power Ranger one.
We will see y'all the next time on Sonic Games.
Hey, I don't know.
This is Jack's
friend. Fuck. All right.
Kinston, probably the first Kinston. Launch party for the PlayStation 4.
Oh yeah, you already know. 252 over the K. Yeah.
This is not you on stage, sir. But I'd like to welcome you to the first launch party for the PlayStation 4. What is your first memory of PlayStation back in the day? If you remember.
I don't like PlayStation.
Well, I guess this is going to be satire to you, but no. Yeah. How about you, sir? What was your first PlayStation memory back as a kid? How about you, sir? What was your first PlayStation memory back as a kid? Let me turn it down.
Grand Theft Auto San Andreas. That was that stuff, bro.
And PlayStation 2?
So yeah, you PlayStation
started,
2.
You started that too. Sony back in PlayStation 2?
Yeah. I started off PlayStation. Tekken. Shit.
Oh, yes. Hell yes.
PlayStation 1. PlayStation 1? Back in the day. Good. How about you? What was your first memory?
I started off at PS2 playing Tony Hawk.
That's what back in the day. Yeah.
Still can't skate.
Pro skate.
How about you, sir? What was your first PlayStation memory?
PS2, let's see, Dragon Ball Z, Budokai 2, and
God of War.
God of War.
And San Andreas.
San Andreas. How about you, Quinn? What was your first PlayStation?
I played almost every generation of PlayStation, ladies and gentlemen.
What was your most memorable?
Tekken 3. Like, I played the hell out of that game every day, faithfully.
I played it this year.
Fighting Saturn. And how about you, sir? What was your first PlayStation memory?
Same as this guy, however, not Tekken, but Resident Evil.
You creep.
And who's the next Xbox player right now?
Right here.
You already fucking know, dog. Bad influence.
Hey, this camera.
I guess for the Xbox players, what do you think of Sony? Healthy competition, no competition.
This is all I gotta say for Sony.
Jerry.
Like, I like both, really. I'm not the type of guy that takes sides.
So, well, as long as it brings the games,
yeah, yeah. Yeah.
That's what all bitches say.
You trying to
negotiate? What do you think, Sony?
I like Sony. I like both of them, but I start out with the Xbox and I stick with it ever since, so.
But are you going to get a PlayStation 4?
Maybe one day.
When the PS6 comes out.
PS6, that's like 10 years, buddy.
It may be 20, I don't know. I don't know.
I like 10 years is fine.
So I get the PS. Hopefully I get the PS4 when December 1st comes out, if they have any more in stock. Amazon better get on there.
Yeah, I'm gonna get one of this as soon as I get a nice good hooker. I'm gonna put her on the street corner.
What?
Where you been going that IRS check? What you mean?
I grew up with PlayStation first, so of course I'm used to their controller. Xbox is good and everything. I like the way there's some of their game graphics look better than PlayStation. I'm just not used to their big bulky controllers. Like, they need to have that under control. But at the same time, PlayStation controllers mess up just as much, because even though they're kind of easy to maneuver, they're more like a brick.
Right.
Something always going wrong with my controller when I get.
My first memory was actually with Nintendo back in Pokemon Stadium 2. Yep. So Nintendo was actually my first console. But I do remember the PlayStation with Crash Bandicoot. I'm almost surprised none of you mentioned Crash Bandicoot. Crash Bandicoot, Spyro.
Spyro,
but I was the longest Nintendo fan for the longest time. Super Smash Bros, Legend of Zelda, Majora's Mask.
Given
the first Nintendo console was Super Nintendo, I remember. Because back as a kid, I had the appendicitis. And I remember playing in the hospital room, A Link to the Past. And A Link to the Past 2 is actually out right now for Nintendo 3DS. Right over there. Nintendo 3DS.
Oh, wow.
And I kind of forgot, but we need to also introduce to your show, our review is right now for the PlayStation launch party and the PS3, I guess, last hoorah, which is now last generation now. PS4 is now current gen.
Woo!
Introducing.
Hey.
All right, my name's Ashley.
Y'all know who I am, but I'm Coley Dix. I'm the crazy person in the group.
Melly D. PS3.
Hey. I wasn't prepared for this.
Seth.
Also known as Yeti.
Faggot.
My name's Matt.
Alright.
My name's Matt.
Christian
Demon
Nightwolf.
Oh, shit. Yeah. Last episode of Star Wars Falls. Better remember this face right here.
Not typically the last. But yeah, we were the last.
Beer Deck, you need to introduce yourself.
That guy with the.
Hey, man! Guy! He's wearing the red, right, man? Turn your face.
I hear y'all. It's just that the Reaper is just. Ignoring
damn the Reaper.
Well, the Reaper better get back into adjusting mode and say what his name is.
He's not in the world.
Hey guys, my name is Justin Taylor. I'm in the Sonic Show, and well, I like games.
That was the gayest
game. I'm fucking ready, dog. I'm fucking ready.
Let's go. Okay, so we're
killing that shit, bro.
Dude,
right,
man.
But the schedule today will obviously start off with the old generation crew playing Rock Band 3. Well, that'll probably take an estimate of 45 minutes, and then we'll begin with the Black Ops 2 competition.
We have six teams hours. Is following. He's worried about what time. Right. How long
and then team that's following will be Seth and Dustin, Quentin.
That would be funny.
Quinn,
and Coley,
right?
And we know a little bit
of Ashley and Novin.
We're going with
I'm sorry. Matthew and Coley. Wait, no. Who was your teammate?
Coley.
It was Coley. Me and Christian to see who we're gonna battle out and see who's the best Black Ops 2 team.
Oh,
there will be rules though. That'll be announced as it happens. And then to the people who have not played Call of Duty, we'll show you a sneak peek of Battlefield 3 before jumping into Battlefield 4. And then last but not least, we'll show you the first unboxing, the PlayStation 4. We'll be playing WrestleGun and Battlefield 4. Really? And show you the user interface and the all little shiny stuff on the PlayStation 4.
You really don't know.
You're gonna see some shiny stuff.
I am proud to be your host for this event.
We're still doing zombies, right?
And I'm glad to be recording it.
I'm proud to usher in this new generation with all of you, and I hope you enjoy it. What's to come in 2014 and beyond? Greatness awaits.
Thank you, nice.
Big ass team.
Big ass team.
Hey, system overdone.
Really?
Dude. System overdone.
Break the ball, yeah.
Oh, yeah. You have the left, so you get it. Just remember that you have the left.
I do. Green.
He was like, oh, my God.
I
got
this.
Hey, George.
Wow.
What's
up?
Hey, Quinn.
Hey, yeah, no,
I need to do it, bro.
So now we're going to Black Ops 2, ladies and gentlemen. Black Ops 2, they are playing Team Deathmatch, and it's New Sound 2025.
act like hell. What the hell?
What?
That shit lagging for us, bro. It's cause we got two systems running. Every time I jump, it's freezing me in the air.
PS3 and PS2
kind of.
PlayStation.
It's the same size as its brethren. It has more of that PS2 feel, but it's more like a PS3. Nice and sleek.
And it's thin.
Yeah. It can always come up in thin.
Welcome to the next generation of games.
Now watch this. The next time you see a slim PS4, it's just going to be that.
That will be cool.
Hey, look, the only thing they don't get for is saying that's the MacBook.
And now we're going to break, and he will, while you're saying this stuff, you're going to go to break, but when we come back, gameplay like a...
That's why games took longer to create. Like The Last of Us, that has been in development for 2+ years. And then about last year, at the Spike Video Game Awards, they announced it. Top Secret Project from Naughty Dog, the creators of Uncharted. And because of the still processors, the development of games was a little bit difficult. Skyrim plagued with problems. See, it was better for the Xbox 360, despite the Xbox 360 having several discs, it was easier to develop. See, Mark Cerny took several years to learn something known as the x86 architecture. Because of the x86 architecture, the PS4 would be easier to develop. One of the games, Octodad's Deadliest Catch, it was easy. It was actually an indie developer. Another game known as Nat, Mark Cerny had a hand in it, but from what I read, only 2 developers worked on it. Mark Cerny was also the guy who had a hand on Crash Bandicoot. So they're saying Mark Cerny is the lead architect of both the PS Vita and the X64. So the guy who made the PS Vita, he had a hand in it. So they're saying with the X86 architecture, games will be easier to develop. They're saying they want to go back to the PS2 era of making video games. Say like maybe 6 months, a year, bam, there you go. No more 2 years, no more development cycles, no more development though. And with more indie developers wanting to check out the DualShock 4 and the PlayStation 4, a lot more games will be coming. Online games, Warframe, Warhawk, DC Universe, PlanetSide 2, and more to come. There was actually a Korean game known as Blade and Soul, pretty looking game, might come to the PS4. Diablo 3, PC only, now for the PS4 and PS3. And then, of course, the bad thing is you have to pay for PS Plus. However, with PS Plus, you get free games, discounts on games, cloud saving, instantaneous updates, and also there's a thing called PlayStation Now.
Oh wow, look at that.
That is the PlayStation app. It's, say it's like the PS3 interface or PS4 interface in the screen.
With the PS4 interface, with the PlayStation app, from only your cell phone, you can download games from your cell phone, or your smartphone actually, and the PS4 will wake up, download it, and then go back to sleep. Along with the PS4 game, you can also stream from the PS4, Twitch TV, Ustream, see the gameplay, put the link on the web, anyone can see your game. If you get the PlayStation camera, people can see your face on your screen. Say you play a scary game, people can see your reaction. You're doing a comedy satire right there. You can also share your screen. Using this one here called Share, right here, you can spend up to 15 minutes of gameplay and upload it to your Facebook, Twitter, same thing with screenshots. Say you got a killer screenshot, share on Twitter. Show it to the world. And also, unlike the PS3, say in the middle, there's this thing called the touchpad.
How about you get the light on it?
Touchpad. Innovative technology, and each of the developers are doing something different. Minimap, radar, and possibilities are endless. However, what is quite sad though is that select and start are no more. It's now replaced by options and share. Notice the fits. Fits the groove of your thumb. The indented so it fits your thumb. And also light bar technology. However, to harness light bar technology, you need the PlayStation camera. This will show the position of the camera. This is your position and or change colors depending on who you are. Say you play one, blue, red, pink, yellow, it'll tell you what you are. So instead of this, color. Also, you on the PS4, unlike the PS3, you cannot charge when it's turned off. Now that it's turned off, you cannot charge. So say you go and take a break, no problem. Put it in, it'll be charged. That's it, it'll charge.
That is crazy.
Now, gentlemen, we're about to connect the PS4 and then step into the next generation of the game.
Woo!
Everything will be called. Is it like true that you could play like previous generations of PS games and stuff like that? Because I really think, unfortunately, you cannot play previous generation games. However, Sony is working on technology known as Jetpack technology that will launch in 2014, which will all your PlayStation 1, PlayStation 2 games all from the cloud to the PS4. And they said that the PS4 should download games really easily, so if that's the case, streaming your old games will be easy. However, I cannot tell you the date when the PS4 Jetpack technology will come. Actually, they said that the PS4 controller is similar to the Xbox 360. On an article from IGN, Sony did say that they got inspiration from Microsoft 360 controller. So they said it was more used to shooting. So, not stealing all the way from Microsoft's controllers, they took some designs of it, such as the bumper. So a lot of developers now are saying that the PS4 is a little bit more responsive to shooting.
Yeah,
thank you.
Yeah,
I don't
know. Top there.
You can feel it.
It's a kind it's of. Really it's a game. It's like from the old PS1, 1, 2, and 3 games. It's like same right?
It's like you have more grip here.
Yeah,
you know how when you would get greasy right here, you're sure you got bad grip.
Of course.
Oh,
hey, bro.
Hey.
I'm
behind
the chain,
bro.
You get out there.
Where's the controller?
All I need is Battlefield 4, my one controller.
I'm not worried.
You can take
controller. I know when I come over, but I
want to
be
able to. That is an overview of the PlayStation 4, the controller, the system, how it compares to the PS3 Slim and the PS4. Now let's connect this bad boy.
Hey, you know we all finna die, right?
We
all gonna randomly come buzzing. Boom!
There we go, fellas.
Oh, there we go. Hey, it looks the same.
That's a PS.
Fuck that. Fuck that. I gotta change it. Now, fuck that.
Oh, you hear this gorgeous music?
What the heck?
It sounds like heaven.
I don't hear the same thing. What the heck?
Jesus is popping
in.
Damn.
The Jesus is king now?
It changed again.
That's how you know it's real. It's
just like, so the yellow is just the charging. This is the actual first paper. So let's see. What language long is it? Obviously we're in.
Use the touchpad to see if
we're not in the United Kingdom. We're in the United States.
Use the touchpad.
For right now it doesn't have it. Check in network development.
Like, go fight
solo.
Damn.
Here's
my feelings, man.
He's like, use my phone. What network do you
want to
use, suddenly?
Isn't it like...
Yeah, we... So... Hold on.
Baby, go back.
Got a body crossing.
Hello, one more. Okay, no, never mind.
Okay. So, George, tell me. From co-host to co-host, right? Now that you actually turn this thing on, and I know it's currently updating right now, what do you think of this PS4 now that you witnessing for yourself instead of looking at all these videos for the past I don't know how long.
It's fucking amazing.
Like this sleep. So like, what's the best feature so far? You know, we ain't gotten the gameplay yet, but what's the best feature so far?
I would say the user interface, how easy it was to set up. But then again, I don't remember how setting up the PS3 was.
Yeah, it's been, the way I seen it, the way I take it is like this. Like, it looked like it's running so much smoother than what the PS3 is.
And it's an interesting note, I didn't use none of the cables, all the cables are over there. I used all the cables from the PS3 to connect this bad boy.
Oh, wow. So, you know what? That's a very interesting point you brought up, because the power cord is the same power cord that we used since the PS1.
He did not
exactly. Y'all notice that, right? The same cord from the PS1, it's been carried over. Yeah.
I was going to say, you got spare.
Okay, hold on.
Yep.
Seriously? Yeah, when they came to the same pick as them? Oh, yeah, you chose it. Yeah, I mean, I'll take it. Yeah, they gave me the same pick that you already got. Hey, shit. How they got your name now, but... George, you go, redeem this $10 thingy real quick. You good. It don't look really different.
They kind of look the same. Wrestle game, Wrestle Gun is free for 50 plus members. Down. Oh, wow. He tried, that's all that matters. No, I don't. I let the downloads. And look back there. Press the PS button. You're back, and that's down.
Instead of waiting for that, do you want to sign out the PS?
Yeah. Now let's see if we can get this up and running. Anyone that has a laptop, we'll see what's going on. Okay.
Oh yeah, he's about to get that Twitch set up.
And yeah, it showed it on the main screen now too. The game download.
Turn off the lights and let's light up.
Douse.
So you can download while you're playing the game.
Yes.
Nice.
All right.
Unlike PS3, you had to wait
straight to the background.
You had to wait till you download. You can't.
I forgot to install Battlefield 4.
Is this gonna take a minute?
It was updated app to use network features.
I'll do that later. We'll just
let me tell y'all what took a long time to download. Fucking Grand Theft Auto 5. No, the first disc.
When they had DC Universe Online, that shit took for me 2 fucking days, yo. What?
2 entire days to download, and I had a 100% internet, bro. That shit was wired. Yeah, I don't remember that. Everybody seen that before we had the beta.
Can you see, bro?
I'm already used to this. It's crazy.
Easy now. Position.
pad.
Yes. threat responds. Large building of Chinese military around target point. Looks like spec ops. Numbers unknown at this time. Over.
Roger. Proceed as necessary. Get them out of there fast.
To save the humans. I think that's about 9 or 10 humans in all. And you have to defeat the boss at the end of this level, which you will see later on. Humans, when one gets free, you have to save them and send them up to the little green teleport thing, which you'll see here in a second. And the human is somewhere detected. Hurry up, save the human, otherwise it's gonna be lost. Oh, this one right there. Ooh, maybe it's in time, but you got another one up there. Oh,
nah,
this one over there. There's another one, more humans to go. Mm-hmm. That's all the healing. Comes the box.
I just made sure I didn't bring mine and everything. I'm trying to find out.
Yeah, people all my history.
Y'all shit is exactly the same. I got my shit in the back from these things.
Where is yours?
I don't know if somebody did it. I told whoever got it, told me to get out my bag, so I don't know.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, this one's mine. Whatever you told me.
That's a lie.
I told you I run my shit, bro.
Yeah.
I knew I did, but I swear I'm gonna look at it around here. Yeah. I mean, it really doesn't matter. It's just the same fucking thing, you know. I'm trying to make sure nobody does it. Yeah. Oh, wow, I'm lucky.
Well, one life left, but you can do it right here. Yeah, you'll just get out of there. Now what George is demonstrating here, it's the fact that he's playing this game and he has Music Unlimited going on in the background too. Yeah, that music that you're hearing is not the same soundtrack with this game. Another example of why the PS4 is the best. So y'all, welcome back to Sonic Show. Now, as you may have noticed, you ain't seen me at all in the show except for during the PlayStation 4 release party. And that's because I wanted to cut things right to the chase this episode, you know what I'm saying? But before I go any further, I got some special thanks to give out this particular episode. Special thanks to BJ Mason, Rashid Ali, also known as DJ Shid, Prince Jersey Dre, and Dizzy to the Joe for popping in as special correspondents for, you know, the Sonic Newz segment, you know what I'm saying? I know I was in forgetful mode while I was doing the taping of Sonic Newz, you know, but, you know, I thought I'd make it up here, you know what I'm saying? Also, special thanks to my cousin, Don Young, for sharing his basketball skills. You know what I'm saying? I'm pretty sure that he's going to make it in the NBA. Only thing you got to do is just keep on striving. Because with moves like that, you never know. You really never know. You know what I'm saying? And last but definitely not least, please, special thanks to our newest cast member, Jorge Hidago, and his family for letting us record his special PS4 premiere party right there at his crib. You know what I'm saying? Like, he didn't have to do that, but he figured considering this is something huge in next gen, you know what I'm saying? This would be something huge to record, you know what I'm saying? So, I very, 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 very thank him for that, you know what I'm saying? I mean, hey, what can I say? Got helpful people in different places, you know what I'm saying? Now, I want to make some other notes as well. As of this air date, usually I say tape date, but this time I'm saying air date. As of this air date, the Xbox One would also have premiered, you know what I'm saying? So those of you that's going around YouTube, you know what I'm saying? No, y'all gonna see those unboxings and all that stuff like that there. So, you know, hey, congrats! I hope it brings out the same joy just like it brought us, as you call Sony ponies, you know, joy, you know, for the PS4. And also, as of this air date, a few days away from now will be Chris's 21st birthday. So, Chris, I know you're watching this. Happy 21st birthday. Get turned up, you know what I'm saying? But anyway, I guess I really don't have a final thought, except by this month being, you know, we're having Thanksgiving, you know what I'm saying? Just be thankful for everything that you ever got, your friends, your family, you know, what you have, because there are actually people out there who aren't as fortunate enough as you are, you know what I'm saying? So please be very, very thankful for everything, you know what I'm saying? One for that man up there, we wouldn't be alive today. So all I gotta say, you know, be very thankful. Also, be very thankful for football, because that's exactly what we're going to be watching on Thursday. Just saying. Next month will be our Christmas, our traditional Christmas episode, you know what I'm saying? So, I wonder what holiday cheer we're going to bring to y'all. Who knows? But, have to tune in to find out. So, as I always say around about this time, be thankful. Eat a hell of a lot of turkey and watch a hell of a lot of football. Alright? Till then, till next month, this is Coley D, and I'll see you the next time on this crazy show I call Sonic Show. Peace. Still